Well, good evening and welcome. Thank you very much for coming. And thank you very much for joining us on Zoom. It's lovely to have you with us. And there are some more coming in. Do sign in, please, on the track and trace register there. This is the first of four autumn reflections. I guess probably most people know that already. The theme this evening is worship God in spirit and in truth. And I'm going to start with a couple of passages of scripture, well, a verse and then two verses from scripture. Psalm 98, verse 1. Oh, sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done marvelous things. His right hand and his holy arm have worked salvation for him. And then two verses that I think are an encouragement. Yeah. Are an encouragement in situations like we're in at the moment, in COVID, in isolation, in loneliness, in the difficulties that we face. Habakkuk chapter 3, verses 17 and 18. Though the fig tree should not blossom, nor fruit be on the vines, the produce of the olive fail, and the fields yield no food, the flock be cut off from the fold, and there be no herd in the stalls, yet I will rejoice in the Lord. I will take joy in the God of my salvation. Encouragement to worship and praise and give thanksgiving to God in our difficult times, which obviously with today's announcements of further restrictions and quite what they mean, but with that situation, we're still in these tough times. But if I could please encourage you to take the order of service, and there on the front page, we are an Easter people. Please do join in with the words in bold. Christ yesterday and today, the beginning and the end, Alpha and Omega. All time belongs to him and all ages. To him, be glory and power through every age and forever. Amen.
Amen.
I'm going to light this candle. May the light of Christ, rising in glory, banish all darkness from our hearts and minds. Alleluia, Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Everlasting God, we give you thanks that our Lord Jesus Christ was raised gloriously from the dead, crushing the power of sin and destroying the sting of death. May we and all Christ's people shine as lights in the world to the glory of God the Father. Amen. The light of Christ. Thanks be to God. So our first hymn of praise this evening, O Lord my God, when I in awesome wonder. Well, if I can ask you just to have a quick look at the little reflection sheet that was beside where you're sitting. And those of you at home, you can get one emailed to you later on, which I plan to do. On this, there's just an opportunity to note down any thoughts that come to your minds as you reflect through this evening. I want to encourage you to use that. And there are a couple of questions on it which may help you or may not. And you'll see that I've also got a couple of boxes there to encourage you that as we sit and reflect, or maybe as we go through some of the hymns, that you maybe write or draw a prayer to God. And then there's also a box that asks if you have any thoughts that you think God has planted in you at any time, but this evening particularly, about our two churches, about the present or the future, then please do make a note down on there. And if you need more space, the space on the back, the space in your orders of service, and all that type of thing. And I do encourage you to feed back to me. There'll be a chance in the service, and then feed back to me afterwards, either by dropping the sheet into the yellow box at the back of church, or by emailing to me what you have come to your mind as you've been sitting here this evening. I want to just look there at that first question, which says, what does it feel like being able to worship together in church again? That's one of the questions that you might want to reflect on. Worshipping, saying to God how worthy he is of our praise, saying to him what he means to us, giving him thanks. Worshipping, but also worshipping together, and that's been a wonderful thing that we've been able to do through lockdown, and I've really appreciated that. And then that third word there, church. So worshiping together in church. And here we are re-entering church. And from what I've heard, we are still allowed to do that. There's been no restrictions put on, or no additional restrictions being put on today. So we're thanking God for being able to worship in church again. And we're going to thank him by reading a psalm together and then praying the collect together there on your sheets. And what I'm going to suggest is that we all say the words in bold, and then I read some of the sections that are in light type, and we will pray through, read through the Psalm 84, and then pray together the collect. So we say, how lovely is your dwelling place, O Lord of hosts. My soul longs, indeed it faints, for the courts of the Lord. My heart and my flesh sing for joy to the living God. Even the sparrow finds a home, and the swallow a nest for herself, where she may lay her young, at the altars, O Lord of hosts, my King and my God. Happy are those who live in your house, ever singing your praise. Happy are those whose strength is in you, in whose heart are the highways to Zion, as they go through the valley of Baca. They make it a place of springs. The early rain also covers it with pools. They go from strength to strength. The God of gods will be seen in Zion. O Lord God of hosts, Hear my prayer. Give ear, O God of Jacob. Behold our shield, O God. Look on the face of your anointed. For a day in your courts is better than a thousand elsewhere. I would rather be a doorkeeper in the house of my God than live in the tents of wickedness. For the Lord God is a sun and shield. He bestows favor and honor. No good things does the Lord withhold from those who walk uprightly. O Lord of hosts, happy is everyone who trusts in you. And we pray together, Almighty God, we praise you for the many blessings you have given to those who worship you in this house of prayer. And we pray that all who seek you in this place may find you and be filled with the Holy Spirit, may become a living temple acceptable to you through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Well, as we come here this evening to reflect, as thoughts pass through our minds, we need to be encouraged to listen to God and see what it is that he has for us at this time, us as individuals and us as churches. We want God to be our guide and we want our thoughts to be God's thoughts. And so we have a section now in our service called Our Invitation to the Holy Spirit. Because we can only really do these things with the help of the Holy Spirit. We can't hear God as well as we might if the Holy Spirit's not there in our lives. We can't connect, we can't have the right thoughts without the Holy Spirit guiding us. And we need to be open and ready for him to come into our hearts, into our minds, and live in us and guide us. So we have a section now. Please do join in the words in bold. All who are led by the Spirit of God are children of God. By this we know that we abide in him and he in us, because he's given us of his Spirit. Come, Holy Spirit. Restore the lives which without you are dead. Come, Holy Spirit. Kindle the hearts which without you are dull and cold. Come, Holy Spirit. Enlighten the minds which without you are dark and blind. Come, Holy Spirit. Fill the church which without you is an empty shrine. Come, Holy Spirit, and teach us how to listen and pray. Come, Holy Spirit. So we come now to a section which has that heading, Worship God in Spirit and in Truth. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to read some Bible verses which are taken from the Old Testament and taken from the New Testament, and they're kind of mixed in and making a little thoughtful set of readings to encourage us and to help us just to think. You might not know exactly what the situation is, the context is as you hear them, but I'm wanting you to just see what it is that God says to you by hearing these words today. And then I'm going to read what some Christian writers have written about worship. So starting with selected verses from Scripture. And God spoke all these words. I am the Lord your God, who brought you out of Egypt, out of the land of slavery. You shall have no other gods before me. You shall not make for yourself an image in the form of anything in heaven above, or on the earth beneath, or in the waters below. You shall not bow down to them or worship them, For I, the Lord your God, am a jealous God. The priest presents the food offerings to the Lord, the food of their God. The true worshippers will worship the Father in the Spirit and in truth, for they are the kind of worshippers the Father seeks. You are a chosen people, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, God's special possession, that you may declare the praises of him who called you out of darkness into his wonderful light. Through Jesus, therefore, let us continually offer to God a sacrifice of praise, the fruit of lips that openly profess his name. For it is written, "As I live, says the Lord, every knee shall bow to me, and every tongue shall confess to God." Make a joyful noise to the Lord, all the earth. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come into his presence with singing. Know that the Lord, he is God. It is he who made us, and we are his. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Enter his gates with thanksgiving and his courts with praise. Give thanks to him. Bless his name, for the Lord is good. His steadfast love endures forever, and his faithfulness to all generations. And now some quotes from Christian writers. I will be starting with the Westminster Shorter Catechism, and then writings from Roland Croucher and Grace Tomlinson, Ian Mallins, John Claypool, and A.W. Tozer. The Westminster Shorter Catechism asks the question, what is the chief end of men and women? And it gives the answer, the chief end of men and women is to glorify God. And then five different themes from these writers. Praise is the food of God, fueled by love. God himself first identified the offerings of the priests as his food. It's not that God needed actual meat and grain to eat. The satisfaction he sought ascended to him through the obedience of prescribed worship laid down in the tabernacle sacrifices. He wanted worship. As often as his people expected to eat, God expected his meals of praise. Offering God the praise he deserves for the unmatchable work of Christ is the true worshipper's daily work, and this is God's food. For this he has bought us, and for this we must live. In a sense, God is leading us to join him in truly living in love, his love to us in Christ, and our love to him for Christ. Here is a feast of love for every day. Our sacrifice of thanksgiving and praise. As we come before God, we shouldn't come with empty hands. We should bring him a sacrifice. And of course, this does not mean an animal sacrifice, for Christ himself has offered himself as our sacrifice for all time. But the Old Testament principle is true. We should bring God something. Often people get nothing out of worship because they don't come to give something to God first. The sacrifice we should bring is the sacrifice of thanksgiving and praise. Worship from the depths of our being. A church and a theatre are not similar processes at all. To worship is to do something quite different from going to a concert or a play. For one thing, the worshipper is the prime actor and God is the audience. The role of the clergy and the choir is that of prompters standing alongside the process, reminding and suggesting. And worship is something worshippers do for God out of their own depths. Worshippers first, workers second. We're here to be worshippers first and workers only second. We take a convert and immediately make that new Christian a worker. God never meant it to be so. God meant that a convert should learn to be a worshipper, and after that, he or she can learn to be a worker. And the work done by a worshipper will have eternity in it. Praise him that he is a great God. Our final theme. When we bring praise to God, we find his presence draws near to us in a special way. Praise him that he is a great God. Praise him that he is king over all gods, the Lord over all the earth. Praise him for what he has made, the majestic mountains, the deep valleys, the rolling seas. Let's thank, honor, and praise him for who he is. This focuses our attention on him and prepares our hearts for worship. So we have been reflecting, we have been thinking, but there's going to be a period now, probably I'm thinking of about 10 minutes, something like that, to just think about what perhaps those songs have said to you, thinking about what the Bible readings have said to you, thinking about what those Christian writers have said to you, or maybe about something completely different. And I do want to encourage you to write things down on those bits of paper and be ready to feed them back afterwards, maybe to come forward and pray a prayer if you've written it. There'll be that opportunity after the next song. So the reflective time is going to be in quiet with a bit of background music, and then through the next song as well, which is I Cast My Mind to Calvary. Through that as well, do continue to reflect, and then after that we'll have an opportunity for feedback. So I'm going to go into just play a little bit of quiet music in the background. And for those on Zoom, the questions and points from the sheet that's in front of folk here.
My mind to Calvary, where Jesus bled and died for me. I see his wounds, his hands, his feet, my Savior on that cursed tree. Body bound and drenched in tears, they laid him down in Joseph's tomb, the entrance sealed by heavy stone. Messiah. Thank you.
So now is an opportunity for feedback, for people to come and pray the prayer that they've maybe written or describe what you've drawn, or to come forward and just share something about the thoughts that you've had and the comments that you've written down. Or perhaps if you've got a Bible verse that comes to mind, particularly if it relates to our churches, then please do bring that forward, and we'll use this microphone here. And if nobody comes forward, then there's another 10 minutes of quiet reflection, however it works. And those of you at home, thank you very much. If you can email in your comments to me, that would be great. And we're not going to open up this meeting for Zoom to come into. I think it would just be too disruptive, noise-wise. But do send them through to me. And I'm planning to put the service onto YouTube, but without the feedback section. So don't feel that whatever you say is going to go out onto the internet. I'll remove the feedback section and ask people to continue to pass comments through to me. So. I'd like to encourage that as we close this kind of time of feedback and prayer, I'd like to encourage that we each pray for each other in silence. Now, you might not know everybody, you might not know everybody's name, but you can pray for the person two pews behind me and pray that they will be blessed by God. You can pray for everybody. So just look around and pray for each other as we come to an end of this time of prayer and sharing. Thank you to you all for being here. Thank you to those at home who have joined us. Next week, same time here, 7:30, Lament, Sow in Tears is a kind of strapline or heading. And Alison is leading us in that, and we're looking forward to that. I'm looking forward to that already. I think that will be lovely. Do put your sheets in the yellow box at the back of church. Sheets that you've written on, if you're happy that I see what you've written, and it'd be lovely to have that feedback. Or do email me if you haven't written anything, or if you want to take it home and then email, that'd be lovely to get that. I just need to remind you to socially distance as you leave, and officially we need to ask you not to stand in groups outside. We need to disperse. That's part of the regulations these days. So when you get home, pick up the phone and say, I couldn't say this to you earlier, but I want to say it to you now. That's the kind of thing that we should be trying to do. So we're going to close by a response with the heading Trust in the Lord, and then a closing prayer. Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and be not wise in your own sight. Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and be not wise in your own sight. In all your ways acknowledge him, and he will make straight your paths. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and be not wise in your own sight. O Christ, door of the sheepfold, may we who have entered your gates with praise go from your courts to serve you in the poor, the lost, and the wandering, this day and all our days. Amen.